Welcome back to Icons of New India. Today we're coming to you from the City of Joy, Kolkata and the Infinity office in Salt Lake. Starting out in 2000 with Think Tank that provided the first of its kind intelligent IT infrastructure in Eastern India, Infinity, under the leadership of Ravindra Chamaria, today boasts of a slew of IT and infrastructure projects as well as commercial and residential developments. Let's now meet with the man himself. So, Mr. Chamaria, welcome to the show. It's a pleasure to have you here today.
Thank you.
Well, let's start from the top. You've had a very bold and illustrious career. So, take us from the beginning. How was it setting up Infinity and tell us about the first few years?
You know, Infinity was conceived in the year 1996, where hardly the IT was there, but it was coming. And since I belonged to Calcutta, at that time I used to stay in Singapore. We thought we must do something back home. And then we conceived this building. Infinity was the first IT infrastructure in West Bengal, in Eastern India. When we started conceiving Infinity in 1996, it was an alien thing as far as the industry is concerned. You know, thinking of fully wired building, 100% power backup, 100% air conditioning, our own MBBS, 32 MBBS line. At that time, 32 MBBS was a big thing.
Yeah.
You know. So it was little, you know, everybody was, you know, saying that what are you doing, it's crazy. But we thought that no, if the IT has to come, the infrastructure has to come first. And then we built a first absolutely world-class IT infrastructure. First building was delivered in the year 2000. The Honorable Chief Minister, the then Mr. Jyoti Basu, inaugurated it. And then it has been quite a eventful journey.
Let's talk a little bit about the marquee projects of Infinity. It of course all started with Think Tank. You now have projects like Infinity Height, Infinity Benchmark. So let's talk a little bit about these.
You know, as far as Infinity is concerned, in our DNA, we want to do all our projects are marquee. There is not a single project which you will find as a run of mill. We don't believe in that. You know, first of all our projects are green, all green rated. Infinity was the first, as I said, the first IT building, fully wired, fully controlled, fully BMS system and everything. Then we did a second building called Benchmark. So it's really a benchmark in the sense that it's a gold, it's a platinum rated green building. It was, when it was constructed, it was seventh in the world, seventh outside the US,
right,
and second in India. And so again it was a marquee project. Similarly, the lagoon which we have done, that's also a green building on 1,000 acre of lagoon, you can see. Then we did a joint venture with Godrej, that's again a marquee project. That's the largest floor plate in this part of the world. We have a 70,000 square feet floor plate. We have around 2 million square feet of a built up space at one place. That's again a marquee project.
So you also have a very ambitious and exciting project going on right now, the Krishna Bhumi project in Vrindavan. Can you talk to us a little bit about this?
Yeah, that's also a very ambitious project, very close to my heart. Absolutely unique project. It will be an icon. We are building a temple with, basically ISKCON is building a temple. We are cooperating in whatever manner we can do. I am the founder patron for the temple. And it's going to be a 700 feet height temple. And this will be the largest, you know, tallest monument, religious monument in the world. Of course, it will be the tallest of Krishna temple, but it will be the largest religious monument of the world. So it's a unique project. And around the temple, we are doing a township where we'll have around 2000 apartments, 140 villas. But not only this apartment and villas, we'll have a spa, we'll have healthcare center, we will have, you know, medical center, we will have a club and many other facilities.
So the Krishna Bhumi Township offers a variety of styles of accommodation ranging from apartments to villas. So tell us a little bit about the different offerings that you have and who is the target market? How do you cater to a different, to various people?
You know, the idea was to give a range where everybody, all ticket size can be accommodated. We start from studio apartments, which starts at 20 lakhs. Then we go to one bedroom, around 30 lakhs. We go to two bedroom, around 40, 45 lakhs. We go to three bedroom, 60 lakhs. So like that, various sizes, depending on the ticket size. In village also we have lowest at 1 crore 50, then we have 250, then we have 450. So it depends, is the range. So everybody can be accommodated. So the lowest is say 20 lakhs, which is a studio apartment of 550 square feet. And the highest is the villa, 4,500 square feet.
Okay. And what are the various facilities that you offer? Are these available to all the residents?
Yeah. Whether you are a studio owner or a villa owner, you get, you know, first of all, the biggest thing is Vrindavan. You get the privileged darshan of the temple, which is a big thing. Some pujas are done in your name on a regular basis. Then, of course, you have spa, you have a healthcare center, you have a Ayurveda center, you have a medical treatment center, you have full-fledged club with many sports, you have facility to go for darshans of Baki Bihari ji and other places free, and so on and so forth.
The company also places great importance on giving back to society and runs multiple programs to ensure the same. Okay, now let's also talk a little bit about your company's CSR activities. I believe education is very important to you, and you have an initiative called Anant, which provides education to underprivileged children. Can you talk to us a little bit about this? What was the idea and the motivation behind it?
You know, as far as the CSR is concerned, I'm of the firm belief that you are not obliging anybody. It's your responsibility. It's a donation. I don't believe this is a donation. It's paying your debts. And then I thought through that, what is the best, you know, as a businessman, one wants that, okay, my money, my resources are better utilized. So we came to a considered opinion that education is the place where if we put some resources, the multiplier is much bigger. And that's why we started this Anant Education Initiative, where we give scholarship for plus two students and college going students. Around 5,000 kids are benefited on a regular basis.
You're also associated with the Akshaya Patra. Can you talk to us about this association of yours?
So in Akshaya Patra, you know, there was a big, big multiplier of your resources. Like, you know, Rajiv Gandhi used to say that if government spends 100 rupees, the beneficiary gets 15 rupees. Rest is all inefficiency, transmission loss, whatever you call. Latest also, Planning Commission also says that if the government spends 100 rupees, the beneficiary gets 35 rupees. In Akshaya Patra, the whole thing is reversed. You know, first of all, you feed the child. So it's not only feeding. Because you feed, the child comes to the school. And because he or she comes to the school, they get the job. And they get education, and then they become worthy of getting the job or doing something. So from feeding to education, to eligibility to work, and then coming out of the poverty cycle. Because once the child gets the job, at least 4 or 5 people of the family comes out of the poverty cycle. So it's a really, really a multiplier. And at the money level also, if you contribute 100 rupees to Akshaya Patra, government gives almost same or more. So 100 you contribute, 100-125 come from the government. And because of the economy of scale, and because we have all technology involved into our kitchens and this and that, you save another 100, efficiency, economy of scale. So your 100 becomes 300.
Wow.
So at one stage you feel that 100 becomes 30 or 35 at the beneficiary level, and here 100 becomes 300 at the money level. And as I described, the cause level, it's feeding, it's education, it's job, it's coming out of the poverty cycle.
Now, you know, there's been a lot of talk from the government about smart cities, also the initiative of housing for all by 2020. This for a business like yours must provide a great opportunity. So what are your thoughts on this? How do you really see yourself fitting into the big picture, the India story in the big picture?
As far as we are concerned, we have worked out that we will get into housing for all business, you know. Till now we have been only making marquee projects, signature projects, you know, doing some. But always we have been doing out of box. We have never gone as normal things. So all buildings are thought through accordingly. All projects are thought through. Now with the help of technology, with the modern equipments available, we feel that if we get into the housing for all and we run it as a pure industry, bigger volume, lower margin, and really present to the customer, you know, very small cost housing, but no compromises. Maybe the sizes are small, maybe the locality is little far, but we still give them the good quality. I feel that huge, huge opportunity, millions and millions of house each of us can make. So we are on the drawing board to start a very low cost housing, but again, as I said, no compromise on quality. They'll get exactly the same quality, but sizes are small. And the ticket sizes, we are looking between 10 lakhs to 15 lakhs rupees. So affordable for anybody. And there we can deliver 5, 7, 10 million square feet yearly. Not today, but in down the line 2-3 years. So that's the plan.
Fantastic. Well, great. You've mentioned this. I think we've summarized it quite nicely. But tell us what you have in the pipeline currently. You know, where are you and Infinity going from now? And where do you see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
Presently, we have various projects. We have some IT project under construction here, and over 1 million square feet. We own around 6 million square feet of IT space in Calcutta. We are perhaps the largest as far as the IT space is concerned. And we have all kind of space, 3,000 square feet office to 70,000 square feet office. So in IT, we are well entrenched as far as Calcutta is concerned. We are doing an IT park, first IT park in Guwahati, which will be around 2 million square feet. We are doing a shopping mall in Ranchi, that's also fully integrated, first shopping mall. We did one shopping mall here also earlier, which was the first in Calcutta. Now we are doing in Ranchi. In Ranchi, we are again building a 3 million square feet township. We have two marquee projects in Guwahati, top of the line, residential, green. Again, first green building in Guwahati, as far as the residential is concerned. We have this project in Vrindavan. We have another township at Vrindavan. These are all our ongoing project. As far as the future projects is concerned, as I said, we are working on affordable housing, low cost housing. That will be our main volume coming from.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much, Mr. Chamaria, for joining us today, and all the best with your future endeavors.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, we're signing off from the City of Joy, but do join us on the next episode of Icons of New India as we meet with two more game changers. Until then, from the entire team, many thanks for watching.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.